people gather around and kind of clap their hands. She's a great big funnel of joy. You got the boogie boogie bang, Chattanooga shoeshine boy. Well, a China shoe, nickel, this shine shoe makes the oldest kind of leather look like new. Feel it so you want to dance when he gets through. He's a great big funnel of joy. You got the boogie boogie bang, Chattanooga shoeshine boy. Yeah. It's a wonder that the rag don't tear the way he makes it fly. You want to see him fade. You ever pass the corner of 4th and Grand? A little baller in a little shoe shine stand. People gather around and kind of clap their hands. He's a great big bundle of joy. He got the boogie woogie bag, Chattanooga shoe shine boy. Carry chip and go. Clap your hands now, help us out. Ho! It's a wonder that the rag don't tear the way he makes it pop. You want to see him fan the air with his hoppity 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 hop. You ever pass the corner of 4th and Grand? A little ball of rhythm in a shoe shine stand. People gather around and kind of clap their hands. He's a great big bundle of joy. He got the boogie woogie bag, Chattanooga shoe shine boy. Chattanooga, Chattanooga shoe shine boy. Chattanooga, Chattanooga shoe shine boy. Thank you.
And the Chattanooga Shoeshine Boy. And good afternoon, welcome. We have a long show for you this afternoon, and it will determine eventually the five winners who will receive. The overall winner gets $1,200 and the CBC trophy. Second prize winner gets $600. Third prize winner gets $300. Fourth prize winner, $200. And the fifth place winner gets $100. Our judges for this afternoon and for this evening are three very capable young men. Well, most two of them are fairly young. Jim Blanchard, Dee Dee Wynn, and Orrin Hawes. And they're the ones responsible for deciding the five winners. And I guess it might be the only time you'll want to give a little applause to our judges, so let's do it. So we'd like to have Kelly Mooney on stage now with Percy Close standing by over on the right side, ready to go. And Kelly, of course, is no stranger to our talent shows, and indeed, she was one of the most popular ones and one of the most fortunate ones last year. And if I can just get her up on the stage here, Kelly will be able to do her little thing for us.
My name is Julie.
Our first contestant in our finals from Iona singing I'm Not Lisa, that's Kelly Mooney. Number two is Percy Clough, and we'd like waiting in the wings, Brad Oliver, if you will, please. And Percy calls Mighty Q Prince Edward Island his hometown, and he was one of the successful winners, of course, in the Mighty Q contest, and he's singing a song, I don't know, I can't say that Dino was responsible for introducing it to us, but he's certainly the one that I've heard most singing it. It came originally from the island of Newfoundland, and as a matter of fact, it was a song that down in Port Hawkesbury was about number one on their personal hit parade for almost 10 or 11 weeks. And so it's one that I'm sure you'll enjoy hearing this afternoon, especially when you hear it sung by our second contestant from Mighty Q. Singing Sonny's Dream, here is Percy Clough. Percy.
Sonny lives on a farm on a wide open space. You can take off your sneakers and give up the race. You can lay down your head by a sweet riverbed, but Sonny always remembers what it was his mama said. Oh, Sonny, don't go away. I am here all alone, and your daddy's a sailor. Silence goes on, and I'm feeling so tired. I'm not all that strong. Sonny carries a load, though he's barely a man. There ain't all that to do, still he does what he can. And he watches the sea from a room by the stairs, and the waves keep on rolling. They've done that for years. Sonny's never there, and he goes to the highway and stands there and stares. And the mail comes afar, and the mailman is old, but he still dreams his dreams full of silver and gold. But Sonny's dreams can't be real, they're just stories he read. They're just stars in his eyes, they're just dreams in his head.
Number two this afternoon from Mighty Q, singing Sonny's Dream. And I got a feeling you can leave that stool right here because we have another young fella coming up to accompany himself on the guitar. We have Brad Oliver waiting right alongside of us, and Lynn Morrison, we'd like you to be right behind Brad and set to do your work. You know, when you can't find songs that you love enough to sing that are commercially made, I guess the best thing to do is to write your own songs. And here's a fellow that comes from DeGrow Marsh, and he kind of specializes in writing his own songs. He wrote some great ones that we enjoyed last year, and he has a brand new one that has been written for our show this afternoon and written for the finals of our Island-wide talent hunt. So we'd like you to welcome from DeGrow Marsh, singing his own song called We're From the Maritimes. Let's make it warm for our third contestant on this afternoon show. Here is Brad Oliver. Brad.
Thank you very much, Loman. Some people feel this might be a little bit of a protest song, but I think the spirit of it is more maritime pride and what a nice place it is to live here in the Maritimes. Well, you can saddle us with taxes, you can take our rights away. The kids, they're in Alberta in search of better pay. Cut off our unemployment, give us tax evasion fines. But they'll never kill us down east, 'cause we're from the Maritimes. New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, Newfoundland and PEI. We're the people of the Maritimes. We'll manage to get by. We'll still be out there fishing, putting good crops in the soil. We'll make the very finest moonshine when Alberta runs short of oil. We'll go back to driving horses when we go Sunday pitch and woo. We'll bring the schooners back from running and we'll have a snort or two. We'll be dancing every Saturday beneath the candle's glow, as we need no amplifiers to put the fiddle to the bow. Nova Scotia, Newfoundland and PEI. We're the people of the Maritimes. We'll manage to get by. We'll still be out there fishing, putting good crops in the soil. We'll make the very finest moonshine when Alberta runs out of oil. We'll go back with axe and bucksaw and cut our winter's wood. We'll raise our faces to the wind and we'll breathe air they never could. We'll still be out there fishing, putting good crops in the soil. We'll make the very finest moonshine, so Alberta, you can stuff your oil.
DeGrow Marsh and his own song, We're From the Maritimes. Well, as you probably know, we had a whole afternoon and night of dancing last night here in our Coliseum. We saw some marvelous entertainment, but also during our island-wide talent hunt shows, we had a large number of dancers, and we'd like to introduce one of them right now. Lynn, would you come on over and use the slate board here, because they'd be able to hear your heels clicking right down into Georgetown if you do. With Gary Chipman on the fiddle, this is our first dancer of the afternoon, but in competition with everybody else. She's from Georgetown, Prince Edward Island. She's dancing to Big John McNeil. Would you welcome Lynn Morrison? Lynn. Woo!
Thank you.
Lynn Morrison of Georgetown dancing to Big John McNeil. We'd like to have Patsy Carmichael on stage and have Betty Jordan and Mary McClure waiting on the right side, if you will. You know, over in Crossroads, this family, I guess, must be the most dancing people in that particular area of Prince Edward Island. This is the mummy, and she has five more youngsters, and two of them are already dancing, and she thinks she might even get the old fella to shake a leg once in a while. And she has been a winner during our entire show. And as a matter of fact, your family were pretty consistent winners. And you're going to tell me something now. And what is it, Patsy? The prince is real. Okie doke. This, then, is our next contestant, number five on this afternoon's program from Crossroads Dancing to the Princess Reel. This is Patsy Carmichael. Patsy. Of Crossroads dancing to the Princess Reel. And we'd like Betty Jordan and Mary McClure on stage, if you will. And George Beers, we'd like you standing by. And we want to remind you once again that the judging will take place this afternoon and tonight as well. The top winner will get $1,200 in cash and the CBC trophy. The second place winner, $600. The third place, $300. Fourth place, $200. And fifth place, $100. And if you girls will come out, Dina will give you a little help in getting yourself set up for the mic and for yourself. And also we have a little extra prize I want to tell you about, which all of the five winners will be receiving, and which incidentally you may receive yourself if you wish. Down on the far end of the Kennedy Coliseum, you'll see Siemens Booth, and this record album is available there. It's called Our Music. Siemens presents Our Music, music from the heart of Prince Edward Island. And in it we have 10 artists, most of them have recorded their own music, and in some cases they're singing other people's music, but it's a super production produced by John Ellis. And also there's this brochure which will give you a biographical sketch of all of those who are included in Our Music. You may get it down at Siemens Booth, and also it'll be given to the five top winners in our talent show for tonight. And we have with us now Betty Jordan. Betty comes from Murray Harbor. And Mary McClure is from Dover, and they're going to sing for you Somebody's Always Saying Goodbye. Would you welcome our next two contestants, Betty Jordan, Mary McClure.
It's the same old scene. Thank you.
Mary McClure and Somebody's Always saying goodbye. Thank you so much. We'd like George Beers on stage and Maxine McLeod to be standing by, if you will, please. George Beers comes from Brooklyn, Prince Edward Island, and from a most musical family. As a matter of fact, you'll probably remember some of his kinfolk making an album of their own. And George has a song that was made popular by George Jones, I guess. As a matter of fact, it was the song that was mostly responsible for bringing George Jones back into the spotlight in the field of country music. And it's one I think you'll like very much. Competed in her show in Murray Harbor, was a winner down there. As a matter of fact, I think George was the top winner. He calls Brooklyn, Prince Edward Island his home, and he'd like to sing this song for you. He's number 7 on our show this afternoon, singing a great George Jones song. This is George Beers, and he stopped loving her today. Let's hear it for George Beers.
Thank you.
I'd like to send this song out to my father, who was good enough to come in and hear me play today. This is to you, Dad. He said, I'll love you till I die. She said, you'll forget in time. As the years went slowly by, she still preyed upon his mind. He kept her picture on his wall. Went half crazy now and then. He still loved her through it all, hoping she'd come back again. He kept some letters by his bed. Then in 1962, he had underlined in red every single "I love you." I went to see him just today.
We all wondered if she would. It kept running through my mind. This time he's over her. He stopped loving.
And some George Jones music called He Stopped Loving Her Today. During the week, as you know, we've been fortunate enough to be enjoying the company of some of the stars of the soap opera of All My Children. And this afternoon will be the final time for us to enjoy some of their company. And as a matter of fact, we'd like to introduce our eighth contestant on this afternoon's show. She comes from Bridgetown, and she's singing Evergreen with Bernie Shepherd on the guitar. Would you welcome Maxine McLeod? Maxine. That microphone stand, I guess we can make a firm commitment to improve its stability before this evening's show. It gives me an opportunity to remind you, though, that we're back tonight at 7:30 with the second half of our show, and we'll be deciding the winners much later on. Maxine, all yours.
Okay, before we start this afternoon, I'd like to just take a few minutes to mention a few things. The first of them being, I'd like to be one of the many to congratulate Mr. Loman McCauley on his 40th anniversary with CFCY Radio. It's an outstanding feat.
Thank you so much, Maxine.
You're welcome. Second of all, on behalf of Burnley and myself, I would like to extend a very warm and very friendly hello to each and every one of you here this afternoon. As Loman mentioned, we're going to do Evergreen, and it's by Susan Jacks. Burnley and I kind of adopted the song as a favorite of ours, and we hope that you'll enjoy it. And I'd like to send it out to a little girl. She's about 3 years old, and she's my niece, and her name is Kyla. So Kyla, this is for you.
Sometimes love will in the springtime, then like flowers in summer, it will grow
Maxine McLeod of Bridgetown, Bernie Shepherd on the guitar and Evergreen, and we'd like to have Linnea Jordan on stage. Linnea, if you will, and waiting on the side, we'd like Alan McKinnon, Rita Watts, and Kilometer Hearts. He had the opportunity to play so well during the past couple of days, so he'll be sharp as a tack on it. And this, then, is our next contestant, 9 years old, from Murray Harbor, dancing to the Princess Reel. This is Linnea Jordan. Linnea. Dancing to the Princess Reel.
That's one. I'd like to send this song out to my mom here and my sister. And, I've been down and out at least once, or a time or two, but never this far down, and hardly ever this far out. Just thinking of the times we had, some were good and some were bad, but we always together in the end. And missing you will always be my favorite pastime. And doing this song especially for you, because of all just a little bit of hair in the kitchen on your chair. We know how much you love, really care. And missing you will always be one of my favorite pastimes. And doing this song, especially
McKinnon of Charlottetown. His own song, written especially for his daddy, number one daddy to me. We'd like Rita Watts and Keela Matard on stage, please, and Patrick and Jackie Duffy standing by over on the right-hand side of our stage. We're competing for a total prize of $1,200 for the first place in the CBC Trophy. We have $600, $300, $200, and $100 as our prizes. So if you're ready, these are our 11th contestants, Rita Watts and Keela Matard, and they sing about Victoria.
Thank you. I'd like to mention here that I did write this song, but it was easily inspired by the village of Victoria, which is so beautiful, and the people are just every bit as beautiful. So I'd like to dedicate this today to everyone from Victoria, especially my family.
There comes a time in your life when you say, where am I going? Where have I been before today? A lot of what you do has to do with what you've done and where it all began means so much to me. I lived my first
extolling the virtues of Victoria by the Sea, a beautiful place in Prince Edward Island. I tell you, Dino, if you want to move those mics down, we're going to get the dancing boots on here of a couple of people. and get Gary back on the fiddle on one of his favorite songs, I'm sure. These are two of the dancingest people you'll ever want to meet, and they come from Crossroads, Prince Edward Island. They've entered our contests individually at times. They've also entered as a double, and this year they were lucky enough to win as doubles. So would you welcome dancing doubles and dancing to the Princess Reel, Patrick and Jackie Duffy. Here they are. And Jackie Duffy dancing to the Carlton County Hornpipe. And we'd like Darlene Bradley on stage now. And Dino, if you'd like to fix the mic up there for our next young lady, we can get that done. Darlene Bradley. And Darlene's chosen a song that was the theme song for one of country music lady's stories. The Coal Miner's Daughter was the theme song of the show. Sissy Spacek was the one who did it in the show, but it told the life story of Miss Lynn, I think, pretty well. So we'd like to introduce now our final contestant on this part of the program, but don't go away because we'll take about 2 minutes off to get some music in order and be right back with the last half of our show. From Nine Mile Creek, singing The Coal Miner's Daughter, here is Darlene Bradley. Darlene.
Everything would stop.
Loretta Lynn's theme song, Coal Miner's Daughter. That's the first half of our show, but we're going to take about 2 minutes and be right back with the second half. And we'd like our artists in the second half of the show, Wanda Arsenault, Rebe McDonald, Roger White, Brenda McDonald, that's Rebe McDougall, Tracy from Tignish, we want Sasha Hickey,